A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 15th July, on the front page you have visa-free year-long access for pilgrims to Kartarpur Sahib. So we saw the Wagah border meeting which was to take place between India and Pakistan. So that happened. India raised the Khalistan issue and Pakistan has agreed to India's proposal for visa-free year-long access for pilgrims to Kartarpur Sahib. Then below you have railways may buy ready-made trains from private players. So Indian Railways is mulling the idea of buying ready-made trains from private players instead of making them at production units. So presently there are three production units which Railways has: Integral Coach Factory at Chennai, Modern Coach Factory at Raebareli, and Rail Coach Factory at Kapurthala, which roll out rakes for the railways. So now it is said Railways may buy ready-made trains from private players. This is the plan. Then on page 7 you have Marathwada dams have 0.8% water, 2,191 tankers deployed. So uneven rainfall has compelled Maharashtra government to try out cloud seeding also to have rainfall in Marathwada region, where you can see the situation is dire. On page 8 you have India set for new lunar trophy hunt. So India has launched its Chandrayaan 2 mission now, which is going to be launched today, and it is said that the mission would look for minerals and icy deposits. So here you can see exactly 50 years after US astronauts stepped on Earth's closest celestial neighbor, that is the moon, leaving behind giant footprints in human history, Indian mission takes its first step towards touching the moon. So it has a lander, a six-wheeled rover, which is going to be sent to moon. So it is said to be hunting for minerals and water ice. Then below you have activists slam move to import Westinghouse reactors from Kovada. So former IAS officers have written to Prime Minister. So regarding the procurement of nuclear reactors, the Kovada nuclear power project in Andhra Pradesh, for which America's Westinghouse reactors are being proposed to be procured. So this is being opposed by locals. Then on page 9 you have this survey study which says nearly half of sex offense cases not been investigated in time. So it says the 60-day deadline is missed in many states. So you can see this is the stipulated 60 days deadline which is there under the system, that is investigation tracking system for sexual offenses, ITSSO. So it monitors and tracks time bound investigations. It's part of the crime and criminal tracking network and system that connects over 15,000 police stations across the country. But it is seen that many states don't stick to the timeline. So that is reported here. Criminal Law Amendment Act of 2018, which came into effect in April 2018, mandates filing of final reports of sexual offences cases within 60 days. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Karnataka Conundrum. So this is regarding the resignation and the crisis which is the Karnataka JDS coalition government is facing in here. So it says converting resignation into a disqualification matter adds new dimension to a political crisis. They are resigning, but now they are said to be disqualified as such. And this is warlord and war crimes. So this is International Criminal Court's verdict against Bosco Ntaganda. So it is said to be a breakthrough. He is Congolese warlord and he is accused of genocide. And now the International Criminal Court in The Hague has ordered, sentenced him as such. So he was known as the Terminator. He was pronounced guilty of 13 counts of war crimes and 5 of crimes against humanity. So this was during the 2002-03 ethnic conflict in Democratic Republic of Congo. Then the lead article, looming challenges to India's standing. So this article says that in the coming years, a host of geopolitical and economic issues need to be reconciled. So it talks of how we have concerns with China, with USA, so how our relations have to improve as such. So that is discussed here. How economy needs attention. And this is ecological perils of discounting the future. So it says, with growing environmental distress, policymakers cannot shy away from adopting best eco-management practices. So ecological perils are not to be sidelined. They are also important to be tackled. Then there is an important article on op-ed page. On page 13, you have polluted water, overflowing sewage, torment Bhopal gas tragedy survivors. So funds which have been set aside under 2010 action plan for resolving sanitation and drinking water issues here have allegedly been misappropriated by the state's rehabilitation. So such are the allegations being made here too. And below you have law commission to be formed soon. So there is proposal to be placed before the union cabinet in the next few days. So the law commission has not been there since September 2018. We have been doing without it. So now the law ministry has initiated the process of setting up the body which advises the government on complex legal issues. So the 3-year term of the 21st law commission ended on August 31 last year. So now a new one has to be formed. So the last law commission, 21st law commission, was under Justice B.S. Chauhan, retired Justice B.S. Chauhan. And here you have Health Ministry Bill proposes to axe NEET PG. So Union Health Ministry has proposed to do away with NEET for post-graduation and use the final MBBS examination for admissions to MD and MS programs. So this is the draft National Medical Commission Bill, which will be sent to the cabinet soon. And this is midday meals left 900 children ill. So HRD ministry has received 35 complaints for substandard food in midday meals, which is the government program in schools. So this is the report. Since 2016, 35 complaints have been received. On international page, you have next Dalai Lama must be chosen within China. So the successor of Dalai Lama has to be decided, and China says that this should be within China and any interference by India will impact bilateral ties. So we know that Dalai Lama had taken refuge in India. We have given him asylum. So that is there. And this is Pakistan should pay foreign firm $6 billion. So now World Bank says that Pakistan will have to pay almost $6 billion in damages to a foreign gold mining firm whose dig was shut down by the government in 2011. So in damages, this much amount has to be paid, $6 billion, which is also the amount which was bailed out to Pakistan as such by the IMF, International Monetary Fund. Then on business review page, the coverage which is there every Monday, here it is, who pays the price? So this is regarding the minimum support price. So MSP has been announced by the government for almost all major kharif crops for the present kharif season too. So the MSP, the government says, is 50% above the production cost. But the way the production cost calculation has been undertaken by the government, it has taken A2 plus FL. So A2 is actual expenses on seeds, fertilizers and irrigation, and FL is unpaid family labor. But more comprehensive cost, production cost, which has to be considered is C2, which is A2 plus FL plus even the rentals or interest foregone on owned land and fixed capital assets. So there is this also investment input which is required. So land input costs are not included in production costs by the government. So if this more comprehensive cost is taken into consideration, then the MSP which is announced, which is shown in yellow dots here, is not 50% above the production costs. So blue dot shows the MSP. Yellow dot shows the C2 estimate, A2 plus FL in green. So then the MSP is marginally more than the costs. Then below you have Centers push for electric vehicles may make internal combustion engines stutter. So the electric vehicles push which we are seeing in the budget, the Niti Aayog been pushing for it now. So it says that the internal combustion engine auto as such would be affected because of this, and this impact on the auto industry will be having consequences because the industry is already under stress. Then on the last page you have India is home to 1,256 species of orchids, says First Comprehensive Survey. So this is Orchids of India, a pictorial guide, which was published recently. It puts the total number of species endemic to India at 388. So majorly orchids are found in Arunachal Pradesh in Northeast. So there you can see. The highest number of orchid species is recorded from Arunachal Pradesh, which has 612 species, followed by Sikkim, West Bengal, and then Darjeeling Himalayas. Then this is healthy lifestyle may offset genetic risk for Alzheimer's. So good diet and adequate exercise here says that it could make a big difference in Alzheimer's. And this is as ransomware rages, debate heats up on response. So this is regarding how malicious software, you know, asking for ransom are being prominently seen now globally. So the cases rose 60% last year, and this has amounted to around $8 billion. So this is a cause of concern now. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.